Hello, welcome to What is What in August Bulletin. Today we'll be discussing about the important current affairs that have happened in the month of August. So we'll be discussing this based on topics. So just for a division, various color backgrounds have been followed to distinguish the different topics. First, let us see about banking. Reserve Bank of India to ask Paytm payment banks as well as Fino payment banks to halt inducting new customers for the time being. So Reserve Bank of India is going to ask the Paytm and Fino payment banks to stop enrolling new customers. So these were launched in 2015. So India's payment banking ecosystem has taken a serious hit as RBI has halted two of three existing payment banks from enrolling new customers. So why has it stopped this? Because of the concerns of eKYC, electronically done know your customer process, it has stopped this. So as well as cases of more than 1 lakh deposited accounts were also being asked to stop. Airtel Payments Bank is the other payments bank which was a nodal agency. So earlier it was not given permission to enroll new customers, but now it has got the permission to enroll new customers. IFC, a member of World Bank Group, is going to invest 160 crore rupees, that is $25 million, in Mahindra Rural Housing Finance, MRHFL. So this is focused on rural housing. So this Mahindra Rural Housing Finance is going to use the proceeds to extend loans to low income borrowers in villages. The Asian Development Bank and Government of India, they have signed a MOU for $346 million loan. So this is a finance to improve over 400 kilometers of state highways in 12 districts of Karnataka. So 12 districts of Karnataka, this is going to cover 400 kilometers. So ADB, Asian Development Bank, has given a loan to Government of India to improve the highways. The Government of India and the Energy Efficiency Services Limited and World Bank, they have signed a $220 million loan and also a $80 million guaranteed agreement for India Energy Efficiency Scale-Up Program. The program is to be implemented by Energy Efficiency Services Limited. So this is going to scale up the deployment of energy saving and enhancing its access to commercial financing. The World Bank is going to provide $250 million loan facility to Rajasthan for improving electricity distribution sector. So a $250 million loan agreement was signed between Rajasthan and World Bank in electricity distribution sector. Exim Bank of India has signed a multilateral cooperation agreement with the members of development banks of BRICS. So this is to collaborate research in blockchain technology. So the MOU was signed by Exim Bank Managing Director David Rasquinha with the objective of strengthening the cooperation under BRICS Interbank Cooperation Mechanism. Germany is going to provide a soft loan of 120 million euros, which means 990 crore rupees approximately, for cleaning the Ganges. So it is going to provide a soft loan of 120 million euros, which means 990 crore rupees approximately, to India. So this is to strengthen sewage water treatment infrastructure in Uttarakhand. Bharati AXA Life Insurance and Airtel Payments Bank, both of them, they have entered into an alliance to offer the Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana. This Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana, it is a government-backed life insurance scheme. So for this, Bharati AXA Life Insurance and Airtel Payments Bank, they have entered into an alliance. So with this Airtel Payments Bank, it has become the first payments bank in India to offer the Government of India-backed life insurance scheme to payment bank customers. RBI has decided to pay 50,000 crores as dividend to government in line with the union budget provisions, helping the center stick to its fiscal roadmap. Means the Reserve Bank of India has paid about 63% higher dividend than previous year. Previous year it is 2016-17. So it has paid a higher dividend. The Central Board of Directors of RBI, they have approved the transfer of surplus amount of 500 billion, that is 50,000 crores, to Government of India. So RBI is paying 50,000 crore dividend to government for fiscal year 2018 is what we need to remember. State Bank of India has inked a pact with Reliance Jio Infocom to integrate its digital banking solutions, YONO and MyJio application, to boost digital payment. So SBI has tied up with Jio to accelerate digital transactions. So they are going to integrate, merge, we can say, its digital banking solution YONO with the MyJio application. They are going to merge these both to boost the digital payment platform. National Highways Authority of India is getting a unsecured loan of 25,000 crores from State Bank of India for 10 years with 3 years of moratorium on repayments. So this is the largest amount of loan to have been sanctioned to National Highway Authority of India in one stroke by any institution so far. So hence it is in the news. So National Highways Authority of India, we know it is responsible for building highways across the nation. So it has got a 25,000 crore unsecured loan from SBI. This is the largest amount of loan to have been sanctioned by any institution to an organization. So SBI has also given 3 years of moratorium on prepayments as well. Walmart, which is the world's largest retailer, has completed the acquisition of India's leading e-commerce marketplace, Flipkart. So Walmart has acquired Flipkart. So Walmart and Flipkart, they have announced the completion of $16 billion deal that would see the US giant taking ownership of 77% in the Indian firm. So US giant Walmart is going to take a 77% stake in the Indian firm Flipkart, and it is a $16 billion deal. IMF has forecasted India's GDP to grow at 7.5% in 2019-20 fiscal year. So India's GDP, it is expected to grow in 7.3% in 2018-19 fiscal and 7.5% in 19-20 fiscal on strengthening the investment and robust private consumption. So earlier the GDP was 6.7%. So this growth will make India the fastest growing economy in the world. Tata Consultancy Services, it has piped in Reliance Industries Limited to regain the crown of India's most valuable company in terms of market capitalization. So the market capitalization of TCS stood around 7,69,000 crores approximately. So Reliance Industries Limited market capitalization stood around 7,60,000 approximately. So TCS has overtaken Reliance Industries Limited to become the most valued Indian company. Google, during its annual event Google for India, has rebranded its payment app for India Google Tej as Google Pay. It has also launched its new features. So all of us are aware of this Tej app, where we have got some scratch cards or something else in the form of money, which were credited instantly into our account. So the Tej app has been renamed as Google Pay. Apple has become the world's first publicly traded company to be valued at $1 trillion. So in 1997, when Apple teetered on the edge of bankruptcy with its stock trading for less than $1, but now it has $1 trillion valued company. This is the world's first publicly traded company. Iran has unveiled its first domestic fighter jet at a defense show in Tehran. So this is a fourth generation fighter with advanced avionics, and it also has a multi-purpose radar, and it has 100% indigenously made technology. The plane had already been bought through successful testing, and it was waiting for its public display. So the first public display flight, it was unveiled by Iran recently. The Indian government and European Union, they joined together with a 240 crore research program to develop the next generation influenza vaccine to protect the citizens worldwide. So the Indian government and the European Union, both of them, they have joined hands for a 240 crore research program to develop a next generation influenza vaccine to protect citizens worldwide. So both the European Union and Department of Biotechnology, Government of India, so both of them, they have also committed 15 million euros each to fund this joint call for the program named Horizon 2020. So the name of this program is Horizon 2020. World's first intertidal art gallery opened in Maldives. An intertidal art gallery, which is filled with around 30 sculptures acting as a habitat for coral and marine species, it was opened in Maldives. The gallery is called the Coralarium. It is located at Fairmont, Maldives, in Maldives. So it is at a depth of 3 meters, located in a lagoon. Lagoon is a pool of water. So its features are semi-submerged exhibits that disappear and reappear as a tide, and they go in and out, etc. So such type of things you can see there. So the world's first intertidal art gallery was opened in Maldives. Exercise SCO Peace Mission 2018 was conducted. So as part of Shanghai Cooperation Organization initiative, SCO Peace Mission exercise was conducted biannually for SCO members, Shanghai Cooperation Organization. So the joint exercise for the year 2018, it will be conducted by Russia at Chelyabinsk, Russia. This will be a historic occasion due to maiden participation of India. So first time India is going to participate in this one. So it has become a full member of SCO in June 2017. So this exercise, it marks a major milestone in the multilateral relations of SCO member nations. Let us see some national news. The Ministry of Culture, Government of India has launched a new scheme, namely Seva Bhoj Yojana. It is going to start from 1st of August with a total outlay of 325 crores for financial years 2018-19 and 19-20. The scheme, it is going to envisage the central government share of central goods and services tax and integrated goods and services tax so as to lessen the financial burden of the religious and charitable institutions, so who provide prasad, food, etc. free to the devotees. So this is a Seva Bhoj Yojana, which it is launched by Ministry of Culture, Government of India. So the Government of India, under this Seva Bhoj Yojana, it is going to reimburse the religious and charitable institutions who are providing free food. Union Minister of Science and Technology Harshvardhan has inaugurated a genetic resource store facility in Hyderabad under the name Laboratory for Conservation of Endangered Species. The Wildlife Genetic Resource Bank at Lacones, it can store 17,000 vials worth of samples. So currently genetic material including DNA, cells and tissues besides semen and eggs of 23 wildlife species were stored. And it is learned a proposal has been made by the institution to increase the storage capacity. The bank is going to facilitate research and, if attempted, scope for cloning also. Himachal Pradesh Chief Minister Jairam Thakur has launched Horn Not Okay awareness campaign and Shor Nahi No Noise mobile application. In this, adding that blowing horn is creating unnecessary noise pollution and is very harmful to health, so some awareness is going to be bought. So as a part of that, Horn Not Okay awareness campaign is going to be conducted and Shor Nahi mobile application was also launched in Himachal Pradesh. Nitish Kumar has launched Mukhyamantri Kanya Uttan Yojana. A series of attacks over the Muzaffarpur sex scandal have been seen. So as part of this, Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar, he has launched an ambitious scheme which is going to promise to provide 54,100 rupees from the birth of a girl child till she graduates. So Kumar has launched Mukhyamantri Kanya Uttan Yojana and has expressed that the government is going to resolve all the difficulties that are arising for empowerment of women. Human Resource Development Minister Prakash Javedkar has announced that 122 research projects have been selected costing 112 crores under Impacting Research, Innovation and Technology imprint to strengthen research in higher education institutes. So as we know, imprint is a national initiative of ministry to address major engineering challenges that are relevant to the country through inclusive and sustainable translation research. So as a part of this, 122 new research projects had been selected, which are going to cost about 112 crores. The Andhra Pradesh government has approved the Mukhyamantri Yuvanestham scheme that makes unemployed youth in the state eligible for receiving 1000 rupees per month from the government. A website will be launched for the same initiative by the end of the month of August. So in which unemployed youth, they can register their details. So the disbursement of allowance will start after 15 days of registration and it will be credited directly through the bank accounts. The Union government constituted a 4-member group of ministers headed by Union Minister of Commerce and Industry Suresh Prabhu. So this group of ministers, it is constituted for the purpose of advising the Prime Minister Narendra Modi on whether to withdraw from the 16-member Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership negotiations. So RCEP, Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, is a 16-member organization. So whether India should continue or withdraw, this RCEP is going to advise the Prime Minister. Parliament passed the Criminal Law Amended Bill 2018, which is going to ensure stringent punishment for those who are convicted of raping girls below 12 years of age. So the bill was passed in Lok Sabha and it was unanimously passed in Rajya Sabha by voice vote. So the Parliament has passed the Criminal Law Bill 2018. So it is going to ensure strict punishment for raping the girls below 12 years of age. Uttarakhand has become the first state to give ID cards to Gorakshaks. Gorakshaks are protectors of cows. So now they will be known as Go Samrakshaks, which means guardians of cow. So Uttarakhand, it has become the first state to give ID cards to Gorakshaks. So from now onwards, they will be known as Go Samrakshaks, which means guardians of cows. Defense Minister Nirmala Sitharaman and Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, they are going to launch a defense industrial corridor in Aligarh as part of government's efforts to develop specialized zones dedicated to defense production in the state. So as we know, special economic zones are some zones which are allocated by the government for some purpose like industrial development, defense production, etc. So these areas are going to be exempted from the taxes. So Defense Minister Nirmala Sitharaman and Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, they have launched an industrial defense corridor in the area of Aligarh. India is going to triple its ethanol production over the next 4 years till 2022. So if it is tripling, it is going to save 12,000 crores in the oil import bill, said Prime Minister Narendra Modi while celebrating World Biofuels Day. So he has said that they have planned 12 biofuel refineries in the country with an investment of 10,000 crores. So if this is going to happen, ethanol production is going to triple over the next 4 years by 2022. And this is going to save 12,000 crore rupees in the country's oil import bill. The Southern Naval Command SNC has launched Operation Madad for assisting the state administration and also undertaking disaster relief operations due to unprecedented flooding experienced in many parts of Kerala. So earlier, as all of us know, that Kerala was heavily flooded due to incessant rainfall and release of excess water from the dams, etc. So Southern Naval Command, it has launched Operation Madad for assisting the state administration of Kerala and undertaking disaster relief operations. The Minister of State for Culture of Independent Charge and Minister of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Dr. Mahesh Sharma, has inaugurated an exhibition entitled Pratibandhit Sahitya Me Swatantra Sangram, which means freedom movement through prescribed literature, in the premises of National Archives of India, New Delhi. So Minister of State for Culture, he has inaugurated an exhibition in the name of Freedom Movement Through Prescribed Literature. So this has been opened in National Archives of India, New Delhi. The Hisar Airport has become the first licensed airport in Haryana. So it is inaugurated on August 15th by Haryana Chief Minister Manohar Lal Khattar. The Civil Aviation Ministry has approved a proposal for setting up of water aerodromes in the country, with Chilka Lake in Odisha, Sardar Sarovar Dam and Sabarmati Riverfront in Gujarat. So these areas were identified in the first phase of development of such facilities. So the Civil Aviation Ministry has approved the setting up of water aerodromes in the country. So with Chilka Lake in Odisha, Sardar Sarovar Dam and Sabarmati Riverfront in Gujarat. Chhattisgarh is the first state in the country to provide right to skills development to youth. So around 2.7 lakh youth has already been employed in several fields. They are trained individuals have also been working in cities like Bengaluru and Chennai as well. Punjab has become the first state in India to launch a mobile app, I Haryali, to support the free saplings, around 30 lakh saplings to provide to people through Endeavor so far. About 3,25,000 online orders were received through the app, with more than 3 lakh people downloading it on their smartphones. So a total of 32 lakh saplings were supplied under the Ghar Ghar Haryali campaign as well as through the app. Dr. Nazma Hepatullah, Honorable Governor of Manipur, will be inaugurating the project development of Northeast Circuit Impal and Konjam. This is under the project of Swadesh Darshan scheme of Ministry of Tourism. So it is the first project under the Swadesh Darshan scheme being inaugurated in the country. So hence it is important for us to remember. So the first project under Swadesh Darshan scheme, the Northeast Circuit Impal and Konjam in Manipur, was inaugurated by Nazma Hepatullah. So what is Swadesh Darshan? Swadesh Darshan means tour country or tour of country. So Swadesh Darshan, it is a flagship scheme of Ministry of Tourism for the development of thematic circuits in the country in a planned and prioritized manner. So as a part of this, the first project under Swadesh Darshan scheme, development of Northeast Circuit Impal and Konjam was developed. Union Minister of Human Resource and Development has proposed to set up 5-member committee to suggest charges to JEE Advanced in the wake of inadequate number of candidates qualifying the entrance exam. So this committee will be headed by IIT Madras Director Bhaskar Ramamurthy. So Union Minister of HRD has set up a 5-member committee to suggest why less people are being qualified in the entrance test every year. So this committee is headed by IIT Madras Director Bhaskar Ramamurthy. As a mark of respect to former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee, the Uttar Pradesh government has decided to name the upcoming Bundelkhand Express Highway as Atal Path. So Uttar Pradesh government is just naming everything after Atal Bihari Vajpayee in recent times. So like that, Uttar Pradesh government has come up with the proposal that Bundelkhand Expressway is going to be renamed as Atal Path. Prime Minister Narendra Modi set rolling a new slogan, Saaf Niyat Sahi Vikas, about his government as he gave over 1 lakh houses to women under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Rural Scheme, calling it a Raksha Bandhan gift. So Modi has coined a slogan, Saaf Niyat Sahi Vikas. So he has gifted Rakhi homes to women under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Rural Scheme. He called it a Raksha Bandhan gift. The center has sanctioned 730 crore rupees for Gujarat's Sardar Sarovar Dam project on Narmada River for the current year, and also committed soft loan for 1500 crores for the other irrigation projects in the state. So the center, it has sanctioned 730 crores for Gujarat's Sardar Sarovar Dam project on the Narmada River. The construction is taking place. So it has sanctioned 730 crores for that. It has also promised a soft loan of 1500 crores. To provide market link to farmers and to make small industries successful in the state, Union Minister Giriraj Singh has introduced One District One Product Scheme, which will be soon launched in Odisha. So One District One Product Scheme was launched in Odisha. So this is for the farmers linking to the markets and also making small industries successful in the state. India and Singapore, they have signed second protocol amending the Comprehensive Economic Cooperation Agreement, which was signed earlier, to boost trade ties between the two countries. So India, Singapore, they have signed a second protocol. They have amended the bilateral trade pact, which was earlier. So let us see some awards. Indira Nooyi is going to be honored with Game Changer of the Year award by a global cultural organization. Indira Nooyi, as we know, she is an Indian born and she is the CEO of PepsiCo. She is given the award for her business achievements, humanitarian record and advocacy for women and girls around the world. The 2018 Asia Game Changer Awards will be given to individuals and institutions who have broken barriers, defined courage, who have worked miracles and in turn inspired their fellow citizens of the world. Santali has become India's first tribal language to get Wikipedia edition. The Santali Wikipedia, it got approval from the Language Committee of the Wikimedia Foundation on June 28th and it went live on August 2nd. So Santali has become the first Indian tribal language, its own Wikipedia edition. Nobel Prize winning scientist Marie Curie has topped the list of women who changed the world. Marie Sklodowska-Curie, she has a long list of achievements and is extended by adding another feather in her hat. So in a major poll, she has been noted as a number one woman who made a significant impact on world history. She is a two-time Nobel Prize winner in physics in 1903 and in chemistry in 1911. Curie has pioneered in research on radioactivity, well-known chemical element radium and polonium, which she discovered, literally shook the world. So Marie Curie has topped women who changed the world list. Former England captain David Beckham will be presented the 2018 UEFA President's Award for recognition of his remarkable career and humanitarian efforts. Former England captain David Beckham, he will be presented with 2018 UEFA President's Award in recognition of his remarkable career and humanitarian efforts. So he was quoted as a true football icon of his generation. Let us see some important appointments. Director of HAL is C.B. Anantakrishnan, is the new director of HAL. And the new High Commissioner of India to Republic of Rwanda is Oscar Kerketa. AIBD, Asia Pacific Institute of Broadcasting Development, new president is Fayad Shaher. And we have three new Chief Justices of High Courts. Uttarakhand High Court Chief Justice is K.M. Joseph. Uttarakhand High Court Chief Justice is K.M. Joseph. Madras High Court Chief Justice is Indira Banerjee. Madras High Court Chief Justice is Indira Banerjee. Followed by Orissa High Court Chief Justice is Vineet Saran. Orissa High Court Chief Justice is Vineet Saran. United India Insurance Director and General Manager is S. Gopal Kumar. And Colombia has its youngest president, 60th president. It is Ivan Duque. Ivan Duque has become Colombia's youngest president. He is also the 60th president. The new chairperson of National Commission for Women is Rekha Sharma. Try an important organization. Its chairman till 2020 is Ram Sevak Sharma. Deputy chairman of Rajya Sabha, very important. It is Harivansh. And who is the first woman Chief Justice of Jammu and Kashmir High Court? It is Geeta Mittal. Geeta Mittal has emerged as the first woman Chief Justice of Jammu and Kashmir High Court. And Chief Justice of Jharkhand High Court is Aniruddha Bose. And Chief Justice of Patna High Court is M.R. Shah. Chief Justice of Patna High Court is M.R. Shah. Head coach of India women's cricket team is Ramesh Pawar. Head coach of India women's cricket team is Ramesh Pawar. And who's the new ambassador to Russia? It is Bala Venkatesh Verma. And the new ambassador of India to Ukraine is Partha Satpathy. The new governor of Chhattisgarh is Anandi Ben Patel, a famous personality. So the new governor of Chhattisgarh is Anandi Ben Patel. and the 50th president of Paraguay, Mario Abdo Benitez. We have new president for Paraguay. It is Mario Abdo Benitez. Jammu and Kashmir governor is Satyapal Malik. Satyapal Malik is also a famous personality. So Jammu Kashmir governor is Satyapal Malik. And Australia has a new prime minister. 30th prime minister of Australia is Scott Morrison. Scott Morrison. We also have a change in the DRDO chairman, Defence Research and Development Organisation chairman, Dr. G. Satish Reddy. Dr. G. Satish Reddy. Indian Bank Association chairman is Sunil Mehta. Let us see some state news. Actress Raveena Tandon has become the brand ambassador of Sanjay Gandhi National Park. So Raveena Tandon has been selected as brand ambassador of Sanjay Gandhi National Park. Senior diplomat Ruchi Ghanashyam has been appointed as India's next High Commissioner to United Kingdom. So we have already seen this. United Kingdom next High Commissioner is Ruchi Ghanashyam. Hollywood star Scarlett Johansson has become the best paid female actor in the world, according to Forbes magazine. Hollywood star Scarlett Johansson played Black Widow in this year's hit Marvel movie Avengers Infinity War, and she has emerged top on the Forbes list of highest paid female actors in the world. Her name is Scarlett Johansson. Let us see some science and technology. NASA's Osiris REx has begun its operations campaign. Osiris REx is NASA's first mission to visit a near-Earth asteroid to survey the surface and also to collect a sample and deliver it back to Earth. So it is going to collect some sample of the Earth's nearest asteroid and deliver it back to the Earth. So it has started its first mission. Iran's defense minister has unveiled the next generation of Tehran's Fateh Mobin short-range ballistic missile. So Iran's missile program is a major bone of contention with world powers. So it is always in the news. So now particularly US is against Iran's missile powers, but it is seen as vital by Iran to give a defensive posture in a troubled region. So Iran has unveiled its next generation missile, that is Fateh Mobin short-range ballistic missile. Indian origin US astronaut Sunita Williams is among the 9 astronauts named by NASA who are going to fly the first missions into space on commercially provided rockets and capsules starting next year. After years of vehicle development and building anticipation, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration has now put the crew in commercial crew spacecraft. So Sunita Williams has been selected along with 8 others. So as Sunita Williams is of Indian origin, it is important for us also. Ranchi man develops a humanoid robot. The name of this is Rashmi. It is Indian version of Sophia. So world has seen Sophia robot earlier. So this is Indian version of Sophia and it has been named as Rashmi. So it is developed by a Ranchi man, Ranjit Srivatsava. He has developed Indian version of Sophia, which is a social humanoid robot. And it is developed by a Hong Kong based company named as Rashmi. So it can speak Hindi, Bhojpuri and Marathi along with English. This can be said as the world's first Hindi speaking robot as well. Aditya L1 is India's first mission to study the sun. So NASA has launched its Parker solar probe in space in order to study the sun's atmosphere, known as corona. Sun's atmosphere is known as corona. So to study this corona, NASA has launched its Parker solar probe. So now India also is ambitious. So it is getting ready to launch its very own probe to study the sun. So this is called as Aditya L1. Aditya means sun, as we know in our Indian languages. So Aditya L1 is going to be developed by ISRO, our space agency, to send towards sun. The multi-purpose Barak 8 missile defense system, jointly developed by India and Israel, it will be procured by Israel Navy to protect its economic zones and strategic facilities from diversified threats, and sales for it have exceeded $5 billion. So Barak 8 missile defense system, it was jointly developed by India and Israel. So what is the purpose of this? It is to safeguard Israel from the threats. So Barak 8 is procured by Israel Navy now. India's first manned space flight, Gaganyaan, will send 3 humans into space for 5 to 7 days, and the spacecraft will be placed in a low Earth orbit, 300 to 400 kilometers from the Earth's surface. So first manned space flight is going to be sent, and India is going to send 3 humans into the space for 5 to 7 days, and the spacecraft will be placed in a low Earth orbit of around 300 to 400 kilometers from Earth's surface. Let's see some sports. PV Sindhu once again faltered at the final hurdle. She has lost to Carolina Marin in the BWF World Championships. So with this victory, Marin has created history as the only woman to win 3 world titles. This is Sindhu's second silver and 4th at the Worlds. Young javelin thrower Neeraj Chopra has carried the Indian flag in the opening ceremony of Asian Games 2018. So Neeraj Chopra has carried the Indian flag at the opening ceremony in Asian Games. England fast bowler James Anderson has become the first bowler to take 100 test wickets at the iconic Lord's Cricket Ground. Anderson is only the second bowler after legendary Sri Lankan spinner Muthiah Muralidharan to have claimed 100 test wickets at a single venue. So Muthiah Muralidharan, he has also created history for having claimed 100 test wickets at a single venue in 3 different cricket grounds in Sri Lanka, whereas James Anderson has become the first bowler to take 100 test wickets at the iconic Lord's Cricket Ground. Virat Kohli has become the second fastest Indian to reach 6,000 test runs. So Kohli has reached the milestone in 119 innings, which is quicker than legendary Sachin Tendulkar, Vivian Richards and Sunil Gavaskar is the fastest after he did so in 117 innings. So now Virat Kohli has become the second fastest. First is Sunil Gavaskar in 117 innings, and now Virat Kohli is with 119 innings. India's final tally with the 18th Asian Games in Jakarta and Palembang. So how many medals did each secure? Indonesia has read 69 medals, 15 gold, 24 silver and 30 bronze. India has ranked 8th in 18th Asian Games, and the first rank is China. What are the gold medals won by India in Asian Games 2018? In wrestling men's freestyle 65 kgs, Bajrang Punia has won gold, and in women's freestyle 50 kgs, Vinesh Pogat has won gold. In shooting men's 10 meter air pistol, Saurabh Chaudhary has won gold, and in women's 25 meter pistol race, Rahi Sarnobat has won gold. And in rowing men's quadruple sculls, so the 4 members together, they have won gold for the country. It is Swaran Singh, Dattu Bapan Bokhanal, Om Prakash, Sukhmeet Singh. So Swaran Singh, Dattu Bapan Bokhanal, Om Prakash and Sukhmeet Singh. In athletics, men's shot put, Tajinder Pal Singh Tur has won gold. In men's javelin throw, Neeraj Chopra, who has carried the flag of India in the opening ceremony, has won gold. In men's 800 meters, Manjeet Singh has won gold. In men's triple jump, Arpinder Singh has won gold. And in women's heptathlon, Swapna Barman has won gold. And in men's 1500 meters, Jinson Johnson has won gold. And women's 400 meter relay, MR Puvamma and Sarita Ben, both of them has won gold. Let us see some special days associated with the month of August. 1st August is celebrated as Earth Overshoot Day. What is this Earth Overshoot Day? Earth Overshoot Day, it is an initiative of Global Footprint Network. This Global Footprint Network, it is an international research organization that is changing how the world measures and manages its natural resources. So the date of Earth Overshoot Day is calculated from the data of Global Footprint Network. So Earth Overshoot Day, it marks the date when we all have consumed more from nature than our planet can renew in the entire year. So this year the Earth Overshoot Day is celebrated on 1st August, means the resources which the earth has given us sufficiently, they got expired by August 1st. So next, what else we are consuming in the year? All are, we are overtaking from the earth. National Handloom Day is celebrated on 7th of August. This is celebrated all over India. This National Handloom Day, it was launched in 2015. So it marks the day on which Swadeshi movement was launched in our freedom struggle. This day marks the day when the Swadeshi movement was launched. Swadeshi movement, it was started on 7th August 1905. It celebrated India's indigenous fabrics, weavers and artisans then. So now, to mark that day and also to create awareness about the handlooms and indigenous fabrics, so a day has been allotted from 2015. So on 7th August, National Handloom Day is celebrated all over India. 9th August is celebrated as International Day of World's Indigenous People. In 1994, United Nations General Assembly, it has declared August 9th as International Day of World's Indigenous People. So the day is observed to promote and protect the rights of world's indigenous population. So what is the theme for International Day of World's Indigenous People 2018? It is Indigenous Peoples Migration and Movement. Indigenous Peoples Migration and Movement. So this date marks the day of the first meeting when the United Nations Working Group has met with the subject of indigenous populations in 1982. So that day was selected and it was celebrated from 1994. 9th August also has one more important speciality. It is also named as August Kranti Day. It is the 76th anniversary of Quit India Movement. Father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhi, has started the Do or Die campaign to drive away Britishers from India on this day. The movement started from Gwalia Tank in Mumbai. So this day is observed as August Kranti Day every year. So to observe the anniversary of Quit India Movement, President Ramnath Kovind, he has hosted the freedom fighters in a at-home reception at Rashtrapati Bhavan in New Delhi. World Biofuel Day is observed every year on 10th of August. What is this objective of World Biofuel Day? It is to raise awareness among people about the significance of non-fossil fuels which can be used alternative to fossil fuels. So as we know, fossil fuels occupies a major share for our transportation and all the purposes. So on this day, they try to create an awareness of the importance of biofuels which can be used as a replacement of fossil fuels which we are using. 18th International Youth Day is observed on 12th August 2018. It is an awareness day designated by the United Nations to draw the attentions of cultural and legal issues which are surrounding youth for their development. The theme of International Youth Day 2018 is Safe Space for Youth. The theme is Safe Space for Youth. So the first International Youth Day was observed in year 2000. It was designated by United Nations in 1999 with the adoption of a resolution. World Elephant Day is observed on 12th August as well. It is an international annual event. It is dedicated for the protection of world elephant and also for the preservation of world elephant. So to celebrate this day in India, the Cooch Behar Mountaineers Club, they have started awareness programs and campaigns at Jaldapara National Park, West Bengal. India has pitched for declaring 2019 as International Year of Millets to the Food and Agriculture Organization of United Nations. So India has proposed to declare 2019 as a International Year of Millets. It has requested FAO to declare so. So India's Agriculture Minister Radha Mohan Singh, he has signed a letter to the Director General of United Nations Food and Agriculture Organization. So this proposal, it aims to create awareness about the millets among the consumers as well as the policy makers, industry people and also the R&D sector. World Photography Day is celebrated on August 19th every year. It is celebrated in order to inspire the photographers to share their work and also to celebrate the art of photography. So why this day it is marked? The birth of this day dates back to 1839 in France, but it came into force in 2009. World Mosquito Day is observed on 20th August. This day is an honor to British doctor Sir Ronald Ross, who discovered in 1839 1997 that female mosquitoes transmit malaria between humans. So mosquitoes have been around for over 100 million years, but it was Sir Ronald Ross who actually discovered it. So on this account, August 20 is celebrated as World Mosquito Day. On this day, what do? Is they spread the awareness about the diseases that are spread by mosquitoes, like malaria, West Nile virus, dengue, chikungunya, Zika, etc. 21st August is celebrated as International Day of Remembrance and Tribute to Victims of Terrorism. So 21st August is observed as International Day of Remembrance and Tribute to Victims of Terrorism. The United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres has informed the General Assembly to observe a day for the victims of terrorism. So one day has been allocated for that. In the world, some awareness is brought. So what are the after effects of terrorism? What are the problems faced by the common people? So everything is brought into account. 23rd August is observed as International Day for Remembrance of the Slave Trade and its Abolition. On the night of 22nd to 23rd August 1791, Santo Domingo experienced the beginning of uprising that had played an important role in transatlantic slave trade and its abolition on slave trade. So this day is commemorated as International Day for Remembrance of Slave Trade and its Abolition on 23rd August every year. So the day was first celebrated in several countries, and this day it actually remembers the tragedy of slave trade in the memory of the affected people who were there earlier. International Day Against Nuclear Tests. It was observed on 29th August all over the world. In 2009, this day is declared by United Nations General Assembly as International Day Against Nuclear Tests. The first International Day was celebrated in 2010. So why is this day observed? This day is observed to create some awareness on importance of banning nuclear weapons and nuclear weapon tests that are going to happen. National Sports Day is celebrated on 29th August all over India to mark the birth anniversary of Indian hockey legend Major Dhyan Chand. Major Dhyan Chand was born on 29th August 1905 and was known for his extraordinary goal scoring skills. So he had won 3 Olympic medals for India in hockey. So to mark his contributions, National Sports Day is observed on his birthday, that is 29th August. International Day of Victims of Enforced Disappearances is observed on 30th August. So United Nations General Assembly has declared 30th August as International Day of Victims of Enforced Disappearances. The day was first observed in 2011. Enforced disappearance means what? When a person is secretly kidnapped or imprisoned by a state or political organization and the third party doesn't know. So following the concealment of information about the person, the problems faced by them, so everything will be discussed here and awareness will be brought. Let us see some surveys. India's rank on Global Innovation Index has improved from 60th to 57th this year. Earlier it was 60th, but this year it is 57th. So Switzerland, Netherlands, Sweden, UK, Singapore, etc. all are above India. India has jumped 22 places to 96th rank to break into the top 100 of United Nations e-government development index 2018. Denmark has topped the 2018 e-government development survey, whereas India's rank is 96. Jodhpur has emerged as the cleanest railway station in the third cleanliness survey. The survey conducted for the cleanest railway stations was topped by Jodhpur. Jodhpur is a city in Rajasthan. 7 Indian companies have made it to the latest Fortune 500 list of world's biggest corporations in terms of revenue. So in the list, topped by retail giant Walmart. Walmart is on the top. Indian Oil Corporation IOC is with 23% rise in revenues, which was ranked 137. Akshay Kumar has emerged as the 7th highest paid actor in the world. So he earned $40.5 million in 2018 according to Forbes magazine. And Salman Khan is in the 9th place. And in the number 1 place is George Clooney, who has earned $239 million. Serena Williams, with her earnings of $18.1 million, is the highest paid female athlete for the 3rd consecutive year in 2018. So according to the list of highest paid female athletes 2018, which is published by Forbes as well, In India, it is badminton player PV Sindhu who has ranked 7th in the list. A central government report has ranked Punjab National Bank as the best public sector unit bank in overall digital transactions category in India. So Punjab National Bank is a state-owned bank. So in terms of digital transactions, Punjab National Bank has ranked first in India. We have some obituaries. Veteran Congress leader R.K. Dhawan, Rajinder Kumar Dhawan, was a Rajya Sabha member and a private secretary to Indira Gandhi for a long time. Kalaignar M. Karunanidhi, who is a former Tamil Nadu chief minister and DMK chief, has passed away. Former Hindu Business Line journalist Moni K. Matthew has passed away. She is a retired senior journalist, editor as well. She has won many awards, so she has also passed away. V.S. Naipaul, Nobel Prize winning author, has passed away recently. He is a Nobel laureate. He was given Nobel Prize for novels like A Bend in the River, A House for Mr. Biswas. Naipaul's work reflected his personal journey from Trinidad to London and various stops in developing countries. So he was awarded Nobel Prize in the year 2001 for having united perceptive narrative and incorruptible scrutiny in his works. Somnath Chatterjee, who is a communist and who is a former Lok Sabha speaker, has passed away. He is a 10-time Lok Sabha MP. 10 times he have been elected as Lok Sabha MP. Chatterjee was a central committee member of CPIM. He had joined in 1968. Chhattisgarh Governor Balramji Das Tandon has passed away. He was one of the founding members of BJP's parent organization Jansangh. So he has also passed away. Renowned Malayalam poet Chemmanam Chakcho has passed away. He is a noted Malayalam poet and Sahitya Academy awardee as well. Atal Bihari Vajpayee, who is a former prime minister, has passed away recently. Atal Bihari Vajpayee was a 12-time parliamentarian. He was a prime minister thrice in 1996 and from 98 to 99, from 99 to 2004. Former India Test Captain Ajit Wadekar has passed away. He is a former India Test Captain. He has also passed away. Kofi Annan, former Secretary General of United Nations, has passed away. Kofi Annan, very good personality. He was a Nobel Peace Prize winner as well. He served as a United Nations Special Envoy to Syria also, and also was the first Black African to be appointed as a Secretary General of United Nations. He worked as a Secretary General of United Nations from 1996 to 2006. So Kofi Annan has passed away recently. Veteran journalist and former Rajya Sabha MP Kuldeep Nair has also passed away in Delhi. Nair served as India's High Commissioner to United Kingdom also. He was a veteran journalist, diplomat, parliamentarian and an author. Nair wore many hats in his decades of public life. There are some books which have been released. Untold Story of Broadcasting was written by Gautam Chatterjee. Dr. Gautam Chatterjee has written a book titled Untold Story of Broadcasting. So this is the book discusses about behind the scenes of development of Quit India movement. The secret broadcast that took place between the movement was led by Sri Ram Manohar Lohia. So this book discusses about that. And Bebak Baat, a book written by Vijay Goyal, was launched by Vice President Venkaiah Naidu. So Vice President Venkaiah Naidu, along with Union Minister of State and Parliamentary Affairs and Statistics and Program Implementation, Vijay Goyal, has launched this book. Prime Minister Narendra Modi's book Exam Warriors was released in Odia language. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi's dream was to make a book available in Odia and it should be reached to every student of Odisha. So the book, it will be very helpful for all students who are going to appear in various examinations and interviews. Shane Warne has come out with an autobiography in the name No Spin. As we know, Shane Warne is a spin legend. In this book, he'll be talking about extraordinary cricketing career and his life off the pitch, and besides unveiling several unknown facts in his autobiography. V.V.S. Lakshman has also penned his autobiography. So it is 281 and beyond. It is 281 and beyond. And Sea Prayer is a book written in the tribute of a Syrian boy, Alan Kurdi, written by Khaled Hosseini. So Khaled Hosseini is a best-selling writer. He has written a new book named Sea Prayer. which is a tribute to Alan Kurdi, a 3-year-old Syrian boy whose body washed upon the beach in Turkey in September 2015. The Afghan-born American novelist was impelled to write Sea Prayer by the haunting image of young Alan, which shook the world. Atalji Ne Kaha, a book on Atal Bihari Vajpayee, was launched. It was written by Brijendra Rehi. Brijendra Rehi is a Doordarshan producer, senior journalist and advisor to former Highways Minister C.P. Joshi. So this book is a 320-page book, which is a rich repository of former Prime Minister's selected speeches and photographs, besides having 3 interviews by the author as well. We have some important seminars and meetings. India and United States have held military cooperation meeting in New Delhi and ASEAN Foreign Ministers meeting. 51st ASEAN Foreign Ministers meet was held in Singapore and One District One Product Summit was held in Uttar Pradesh and 24th World Congress on Philosophy Congress was held in Beijing, China. 11th World Hindi Conference was held in Mauritius and 6th edition of International Buddhist Conclave 2018 was held in New Delhi. And India Banking Conclave 2018 was held in New Delhi as well. Indian Ocean Conference was held in Vietnam. 4th Asian Electoral Stakeholders Forum was held in Colombo in Sri Lanka. And 1st SAARC Agri Cooperative Business Forum was held in Kathmandu. And Smart India Hackathon was held in New Delhi. And RCEP Ministerial Meeting was held in Singapore. Let us see some important places. Chief Minister Vasundhara Raje has opened the country's biggest incubation center, Bhamashah Techno Hub, in Jalana Industrial Area of Jaipur. So this is going to provide startups with a unique platform to evolve into accomplished organizations. So Chief Minister Vasundhara Raje has opened the country's biggest incubation center, Bhamashah Techno Hub, in Jaipur. Kanchenjunga Biosphere Reserve of Sikkim emerged as the highest biosphere reserve in the country. So it is going to include the third highest mountain peak in the world, Kanchenjunga. It also had been included by UNESCO's World Network of Biosphere Reserve. So Kanchenjunga Biosphere Reserve of Sikkim is the highest biosphere reserve in the country. So it is having the mountain Kanchenjunga as well. The Odisha government has decided to set up a state-of-art interpretation center at Bhitarkarnika National Park to show its flora and fauna and rich biodiversity. So, a state-of-art interpretation center is to be set up at Bhitarkarnika National Park to showcase its flora, fauna and rich biodiversity. So, as we know, national parks are of immense importance in the recent exams, very importantly. So, here Bhitarkarnika National Park belongs to which state? It is Odisha. That is all in the month of August. See you in another month. Thank you.